throughout the flight, we're in the restaurant at the Aviation Museum. Look how cool it is. Like, what do you see and stuff? This one. I'm gonna show you. I got a sandwich. Ryan got, what is it?
Barbecue chicken.
It's not. He gave me a piece. It's really good. Like I showed you, I just got a sandwich.
Yeah, she got boring. Is it at the Aviation Museum at Pearl Harbor?
Yeah.
Good.
We're about to go into it now after we eat. We just had to eat for lunch. We're watching you eat.
It's not awkward at all.
Say bye for now.
So Amber really liked that TV show, Pan Am. So she's really excited about seeing that on the wall. Make sure you comment below if you
want to watch it.
Yeah. Could you imagine having a plane like this? A plane like this? Hey, Mary, does it look like the TV show? Can't smoke anymore. This is a Japanese plane. I guess it was like a torpedo bomber. Raiders. Remember that scene in Pearl Harbor? Oh, look. Wreckage. It's another Japanese plane. You would be. Amber, I think this wheel is bigger than you.
It is.
Well, not so much. USS Hornet.
That shit went to hell and back.
But this guy looks like Liam Nelson. Neeson, whatever his name is. He kind of looks like number three. He looks like Liam Neeson. There you go, for his uniforms. Fat people like me? I hope not. It's a 1942 Harley Davidson. Not much has changed.
Looks pretty cool.
So I think Amber's a little disappointed.
Honestly, there's some really cool aircraft, like, you know, from the 1940s.
We did. That was the last one.
There was like four planes.
Mm. Yeah.
Like all colored and looking pretty and all that. You guys can leave a comment below and tell us which one was your guys' favorite. Or if you've been here before.
I kind of like it though. It's kind of fun.
Yeah, it's different. I wouldn't expect it to be like
that. I mean, I would never have thought that these planes are that big in real life.
I know. From what you see in like movies and commercials and all that.
But if you're ever at, is it Oahu? Yeah.
Yeah.
Island of Oahu. Go to Pearl Harbor. Do this.
It's worth it. And you get a military discount.
If you're military.
Or a vet, or retired, or active.
Yep.
Which is pretty cool, because then you can go see Missouri, Bengal. You can go see, what's the sound?
The bluefin?
I forgot the sound.
Blowfin.
Yeah.
Whatever.
And then you can take a boat ride to go see the Arizona, but you can't go on the platform anymore. That's like $750.
And you only get an hour, but I think it'd be kind of cool to do.
Because there's plenty of time in the day. Like, they only give us you a specific day. So if you get here early in the morning, you can do all four things. But depending on what time you get here, they only allow
you. I think you need 6 hours, right?
Yeah, you need at least 6 hours to go to all four things. But it's like, what, $79 per person?
Yeah, $72 without military discount or any other discount.
Mm-hmm. Or so, if you're a Hawaiian resident, then you also get a discount as well.
Yeah. It's pretty cool. But I think we're going to head back over to the bus and head out. So, until we see you again, bye. We're done with our last chance or last visit to Pearl Harbor.
We did finally do the Arizona Memorial. That you're on a boat though, because you can no longer walk on it. Also, ladies, if you need to leave your bags in the car, because they have lockers, but I wouldn't put it in a locker. And also have money or a credit card with you, because there's a few gift shops and some snacks along the way to pick up, because it does get a little bit warm out.
Yeah, we were lucky enough to get on the Arizona, which was for free for us. I'm not sure if it was because we had a blue band that we got for the Battleship and the Air Museum. But yeah, no, it was good.
It was very humbling towards the end, because yep, we watched about a 25-minute documentary about it. And when you leave, nobody says anything. It's really quiet. And then you get on the boat, and it's just, it's memorable. And
it is
kind of frozen in time, except you can't really see the Arizona or like the oil spills, because you can't get that close to it.
Right. But no, it's good. Well, and then they also have like off to the side, like almost centered, they have this like little area where you can go in and see all the names of the guys who died during the attack on Pearl Harbor too,
inside of the memorial.
Right.
But there's also like a walk of remembrance at the visitor center, is where your first stop is, where you buy your tickets and then they send you off. They also have a whole bunch of names on there and things as well.
Yeah. But no, we had a good time, as much as you can in this kind of situation.
I would definitely highly recommend it. Yeah. Probably anywhere from half a day to almost a full day.
Yeah.
Especially with some shopping and stuff. That things are a little bit pricey, but you know, it all goes towards something good.
Yep. But we'll see you guys later. We're not sure what we're going to do for the rest of the night, but we'll see you guys.
We'll
be updated. Bye.